Hello again, Knights. We have an all-new episode for you coming up right now.
In this week's episode, we learn more about Drumline, get to relive the classics, and check out a local tree nursery.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's get this show started.
Hi, welcome to the studio. I'm Gabe Grano.
And I'm Taylor Knutschel.
Doesn't everyone like to be clean? Taylor got to know one of our fellow students, Camille Ewald, and learn more about her local soap boutique.
Camille Ewald is a student here at Higley High School. She's been able to balance not only being a model and a piano player, but she also started up her own business.
The name of my business is Cam & Kay's Sweet Soap Boutique, and my business was created in October 2015, and we started it December 4th, 2015. I manage this with, I'm an advanced piano player. I travel a lot for modeling, but when I come home from school, instead of homework, it's all about the soap, because now I'm getting orders from like across the US. Before, it started off as like a small thing, and it would just be like family and friends buying her stuff, and now I'm like getting orders from like New York.
Her sister Kaylee also helps her sister create and sell these amazing products.
My name is Kaylee Ewald. I am the co-owner and co-founder of Cam & Kay's Sweet Soap Boutique. Our products, they're really soothing and they're just nice, and a lot of people prefer them.
Not only are they good quality products, but they have a wide variety of different products you can choose from.
We make them in our factory in California. In Anaheim, so I make all my stuff there, but I also do make it all at home. One time I had an order of like 400 bath bombs that was all made in California at my factory. We make a wide variety of bath bombs and a lot of sweet soaps. By sweet soaps, I mean we make cupcake soaps, donut soaps, popsicle soaps, and a whole bunch more. My favorite product would have to be our bath bombs, just because I feel like those are our most popular items. You guys should buy my products because it's going towards my college fund, and I'm also planning to open up a storefront in downtown Gilbert.
So we also have an Instagram page. It's Sweet Soap Boutique, and it's just me and my sister. We post all of our products, our new product lines. You can also go check that out there. We also have our email for business inquiries.
Make sure to talk to Camille if you are interested in buying any of these products, and check out her boutique online. This is Taylor Knutschel reporting for The Studio.
Higley Spirit Line mandatory try-on-formation meeting is tonight in the library at 6 p.m. If you're interested in trying out for the 2018-2019 season, please come in the meeting with a parent or a guardian.
On Tuesday, Avid had an informational meeting detailing more about college and career opportunities for our fellow Knights. We hope you made it there and got a better understanding.
Gabe, have you ever seen that movie Clueless? It's a classic.
As if. Of course, Taylor. I watch classic movies every Tuesday at Harkins. Stevie and I recently went and caught up on cinema's greatest hits with our fellow Knights.
Hey there, Knights. Black Panther was released over the weekend, and I'm sure you all went to see it, but have you ever gone to Harkins Theaters on a weekday? On Tuesday nights, they have something called Tuesday Night Classics over here on Santan Mall. And for only $5, you can watch cinema's greatest hits. Let's check it out with some of our students.
Five is not his year.
It is basically where they show a whole bunch of classic movies like Top Gun, Back to the Future, on Tuesday nights, and it's $5.
Top Gun.
I really like it because it's only $5 and it's a great place to just go and watch classic movies.
Such an exciting day.
I haven't seen any movies, but I heard they're putting Forrest Gump on the big screen again, and it'd be really nice to see a classic.
I also asked our fellow Knights what movies they've seen and what upcoming movies they'd like to see.
I'm really excited to watch Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. They're showing that in the next upcoming week. And Mrs. Doubtfire is going to be showing, so that's going to be really cool.
I think I would recommend it because it has some old movies that probably their parents have seen, so they can see what kind of movies their parents watched when they were younger.
Finally, I asked them if they would recommend it to other students here at Higley.
It's a good experience to get into.
I definitely think you should check out Tuesday Night Classics because it's really cheap and it's a really fun time, and it's just right down the street.
All right, Knights, that's it for this week. This is Gabe and Steve, and you're watching The Studio.
Best Buddies had a Valentine's lunch party last week. They got together to make Valentine cards and see their buddies. Hope to see you at the next party.
On Wednesday, boys volleyball had their first scrimmage against Red Mountain High School. They all played their best, and make sure to go support them at their first game on February 28th.
Drumline has been able to bring our school tons of spirit. Nadia caught up with a few Drumline members to learn a little more about what motivates them.
These drummers are back and ready to hit up another beat. The drumline here at Higley consists of previous marchers who wanted to continue their spotlight on the court. Shira and Matthew are just two of the students who I was able to get a little information from about the class.
Drumline is a competitive sport. It's fun, it's creative. You learn music, memorize it.
Well, drumline to me is about making friends, having a good time, and kind of in the process, kind of creating a show.
So the instrument I play is the vibraphone. It's a mallet instrument, which uses a pedal for the instrument to ring. It's really pretty.
I play the quads in drumline, so it's basically like six drums attached to like a harness.
They all come together on Tuesdays and Thursdays to practice their piece together, focusing on their technique and overall sound. The show this year is called Simple, and it's about the drumline playing complex, while a higher order wishes for them to play simply.
It's about us as a group doing complicated stuff, and the corner of our band room is named Frank. He likes to keep things simple, but down on the floor, we like to make things complex. And he's the one telling us to be simple and don't overcomplicate something.
Last year's drumline was a huge success, as they won first place in state competition. It was Shira's first time joining drumline that she got the experience a show to remember.
Oh, last season, it was fantastic. The Heist was my first show, and it was really intense and like fun, and it was just everything came together, and it was really cool.
With the win, the students are working harder than ever to hold their first place title. All of the students sharing this common goal.
Well, this year we're trying to get first place at state championships.
To get first place, you know, but also to bond as a group and get stronger and improve the drumline itself.
Overall, we just want to have fun. We want to have a good show, so that's our goal.
This was Nadia Garsho coming to you from the studio.
Next week's deal of the week is hot Cheetos for 75 cents. Make sure to stop by the Armory and get it while you can.
As the marketing teacher, I supervise the students and make sure everything's done correctly, but the students run the Armory.
On this week's teacher feature, Mr. Ellis takes the spotlight as Thomas and Tommy get to know one of our favorite physics teachers.
If you've ever been walking around the 300 building, chances are that you've seen the beautiful tuft of hair belonging to Mr. Ellis himself.
However, it's what's under the hair that we're interested in. We've always heard so many great things about Mr. Ellis, so we went to find out more about him.
I get joy out of doing math, like some people might get joy out of doing sports.
Mr. Ellis started off doing laser research in college. But there was a problem with that.
It just wasn't for me. It was so, there was so much more repetition and monotony in it than I expected.
Motivation seemed to have been lost, and he actually went through a bit of a college crisis. What ensued was a moment of enlightenment.
Somehow after that, I realized, no, you know what? I actually wanted to be a professor, a physics professor in the beginning because I wanted to teach. Not because I wanted to research. I finally realized that about myself, and I turned around and I, you know, recovered my GPA and made it through the rest of my time in school.
We asked some of his students how they felt about his choice to teach and how passionate he is about his teaching.
I mean, I think it's easier to follow money than to follow your passion, but he chose to follow what he really loves, and I think that's cool.
I think he has a blast teaching what he's teaching. It's kind of scary how fast he can do math in his head. It's almost intimidating. But he definitely seems to have a fun time doing it.
There's nothing like, to me, when I try to teach something to somebody and then they get it and they hit that moment. It's just, there's no greater joy.
I'm Thomas Caprice.
And I'm Tommy Parker,
reporting for The Studio.
Our classmates worked very hard to give us creative and fun ways to look back on the year. Carson and Seth got to talk to our yearbook members to see just how hard they worked to make our memories picture perfect.
The yearbook is a special part of Higley that will create lasting memories forever. Miss Goodwin, a graphic design teacher here at Higley High School, helps us dive deeper to show what really goes into making the yearbook each and every year.
Originally, I went to school for computer animation and I loved it, but the jobs were in LA and New York and I didn't want to move. So I stayed in the Valley and I just kept looking for a job until I found one, and I found a job in graphic design and they gave me a chance even though I didn't have a degree. And then I just went from there and I just learned on the job how to do everything. So
my job in yearbook is photo editor. So I make sure the other photographers take their pictures, go to the sporting events, are able to get their interviews and write their captions and get it all in on a deadline, on the spreads, and ready to go for the plant.
Okay, so I'm the managing editor, which means I have to check up on all the reporters, making sure that they have their stories done and on time so we can meet the deadline.
My favorite part about teaching yearbook is when the book gets delivered. And for the first time, students who worked so hard all year have been like, oh, this frustrated, and they don't think it's gonna be good. And then they get the book and they're like, oh my gosh, my name's on that page. They get really excited. So that's my favorite part of your book.
Because the people are great. Like, you just, even if you are struggling to finish a deadline or like a story or whatever you're on, like they're always there to encourage you, and like you have fun no matter what.
I recommend somebody joining yearbook if they have interests in photography and want to be able to create something for the students and for themselves, as well as just furthering any careers that they like in the field of photography.
We hope you purchase your yearbooks right before the school year ends. This is Carson and Seth reporting for the studio.
Make sure to wear blue on Wednesday, February 28th for Spread the Word to End the Word Day.
One of our very own Knights at Higley has had a tough situation. Haven McKay is a very strong and brave student that has a very important story to tell. Zachary Babbitt and Katie Stevenson have the story.
Multiple scoliosis is a disease that eats away the protective covering of the nerves. This can be very painful and can even cause serious vision issues and overall weaken the body. This could seem unfathomable to bear, but for a fellow classmate, Haven McKay, it's a reality.
Before MS, I was in ROTC, was in dance.
We're devastated. I mean, knew right then everything was fixing to change and we weren't sure what was going to change. It was just a new shock.
Haven's life has changed so much since learning about her condition. But for her, it helped her have a different outlook on life.
She's not as tough to deal with as she was before. She's kind of learned that she has to change the way she lives.
It made me enjoy waking up every morning and being able to stand up and walk. Or, you know, open my eyes and actually see in the morning.
Helping her to realize that this is a new normal for her. The rest of her life is just going to be a big learning curve and having to learn how to deal with these problems as they come.
I also learned from her parents about her recovery and about Haven's new treatment.
Well, my mom, she was a big part of it. She went through the whole thing with me. She spent every single day in the hospital, never left my side. You learn to appreciate the little things in life more. I've gone through two treatments of medicine. I did one that was a pill every day. It worked for a while and it helped me actually start walking again. And then my second treatment I just started not too long ago. It's actually worked out a lot better. I've had less problems and less migraines.
During the recovery process, we went to physical therapy 3 days a week, and it was tough for me to learn how to get her in and out of a vehicle and from her wheelchair.
Keeping her strong, keeping her encouraged, getting her where she could get back to where she's on her feet again.
Although Haven's treatment has been helping, she's still struggling every day. Reporting for the studio, this is Zachary Babbitt and Katie Stevenson.
Taylor, what exactly is a tree nursery?
I don't really know, Gabe. But Jacob and Mitch can tell us more about it.
On this rainy afternoon, many of you may feel gloomy, but the life at Desert Horizon Nursery is anything but. Mitch and I were fortunate enough to get an inside look at this fascinating business.
Well, one of the biggest things that we sell and what we started out with are plants. So we sell a huge variety of trees, shrubs, cactus, succulents, annuals, fruit trees, and then we sell all the implements that go with that. So we sell, you know, garden items. We have statuary. We have fountains. We have metal art, trellises. We have, you know, fertilizers. We have everything that you would need to make your garden beautiful and successful.
The Desert Horizon Nursery is a family business that grows on about 25 acres of land. They are set apart as being one of the only places that actually grows what they sell.
Our plants here grew up here. So they're used to our winters, they're used to our summers. You get a much better plant for the value.
And if you can see, they barely start out. See how tiny they are? They start to sprout. And then we transfer them into their own little buckets.
They are also an impactful force on the community, being a donor of many of their plant life.
We have provided so many of the plants that you see in Queen Creek, even in a lot of the commercial areas, which we make a ton of donations to the community.
The Desert Horizon Nursery also has a landscaping team that takes all the hassle out of making your backyard beautiful.
From ground up, we can do pavers and ramadas and fire pits, and we can do everything ground up. We try to carry merchandise that you can't get at Target or Walmart, that you have to come here for. We try to keep things very, again, I said relevant, very interesting for people, so that when you come here, you might see something completely different than you saw 2 weeks ago.
The Desert Horizon Nursery is a place where everyone is welcome. Be sure to check them out on the corner of Ellsworth and Germain. Reporting for the studio, I'm Jacob Steakbake.
We hope you enjoyed this week's episode.
Make sure you follow us on all of our social media to keep up with events going on around the school. We'll see you next week.
Down the drum began to swing. You should have heard the knocked out jailbirds.